Will and I could not figure out how to get this gimbal to lock in place on my phone. I think my phone is heavier than Will's. Welcome in. Hi, everybody. Welcome in. I am here. I am here at Epcot, live at the Flower and Garden Festival. Let me get back around and let's look at this topiary. No one's standing in front of it right now. So beautiful. So this is the new topiary this year. Last year Encanto was here. So this one is new this year. We've got Asha and the star from Wish. And we've got the goat whose name totally escapes me right now. But it's super pretty. She is made of succulents. So she is succulents. We have the sign right here. So let's go in. Welcome in, everybody. Welcome in. We are glad you're hitchhiking with us tonight. Let's go find this Flower and Garden Fest is tonight. So I'm gonna do some of that. I'm gonna start with some rides first. So we're gonna ride some rides first and then we're gonna go walk around the World Showcase. I may do the Skyliner. Depends on how long my phone battery lasts. Depends on how long my phone battery lasts. I've got it to charge as much as I can. But there it is. The ball, the golf ball, spaceship Earth, whatever you like to call it. Hello, welcome in, surfer girl. There it is. So I think we're gonna head to Nemo first. So let's head to Nemo first. You know, honestly, for being spring break, the crowds are not terrible at all. We were at Animal Kingdom yesterday and we did buy Genie Plus. It was $25. That's a whoopin' for Animal Kingdom. It's normally around 12 to 15, but it was so worth it because we got so much done and we even got to redo some stuff. So Spaceship Earth is at a 10-minute wait right now. We'll come back and do that because I know it kind of gives out on the stream. So we'll come back and do that later. But Epcot, honestly, I've been checking wait times all day. I was at a travel agent training on the Disney Wish this morning. And I did that in Port Canaveral from 10 a.m. to 3 is when the tour was. It took about an hour to get there and an hour to get back. Yes, I'm excited my mom was able to come too. There's so much that she hasn't done. I'm gonna try to fix my phone. Hold on, it's leaning a little bit. We got some gimbal craziness happening. Okay. My phone weighs a lot more than Will's does, so it's kinda, this gimbal's like, why are you so heavy? So I have also not seen the Dreamer statue yet and all the new part. And I'm so excited Walcott is finally down after what seems like a million and 5 years. So we are gonna head to the Seas and the Land Pavilion first. Gonna get some rides in, but yeah, I've been watching Epcot's times, wait times today, and it's not been bad at all. I mean, Frozen is always pretty long, Remy is always really long, and of course, you've got to get your Guardians virtual queue or Lightning Lane at that 7 a.m. time slot. So, let's go see what's happening with Nemo and his friends. And I don't know how this is gonna stream, so you guys just, you know, follow along and we'll see how this goes. This is where Moana is normally meeting right here. They stop character meet and greets normally anywhere from 3:30 to 4:30. Her little time is not out. And then, of course, the monorail's right there, Coral Reef Restaurant. And then we've got Journey of Water over here. There you go. So we'll try to do that too. I think it's really pretty at night, so we'll try to wait a little bit. Hi, Will. Hi, Wyatt. Hi, Wesley. Thank you, Will, for allowing me to come with my mom and to do that travel agent training this morning on the Wish. It was incredible.
Yeah.
I have so many pictures. Hopefully we can get some posted Instagram later on our account at the Hitchhiking Bones. We're on Instagram and Facebook as well as YouTube. So we'll get some pictures posted of the Wish. It was like, man, it was so incredible. Everything about it was incredible. And I cannot wait to plan some vacations and make some magic for people. So here we are at the Seas. Woo, that water scared me. So it's a standby of 5 minutes, so let's go. Right, the Seas with Nemo. And of course, this is a lightning lane. You can lightning lane it. Today, you honestly didn't need to. It stayed at about a 5 or 10 minute wait the whole day. Bear with us again. I don't know how this is gonna stream, but we're gonna try it. Yes, Dean in the big blue world, in the big blue world. I'm sorry you're not here, Dean. I know you were trying to make it, but I get it. Okay, I'm sorry. Hold on.
Back there, let's see. Don't feed them, boy.
We have some gimbal craziness. It just like did something crazy. Okay. There we go. I'm sorry. My phone is, I mean, it's a lot heavier than Will's, so hopefully it's fixed now. In the line queue for the Seas with Nemo and Friends. And of course, on this ride, at the very end, make sure to check out the aquarium. And I'll show you some really cool aspects about the aquarium. This is the longest line queue in the history of line queues. It's what it feels like. It's really not, though. But. So yeah, I was on the Disney Wish this morning, Port Canaveral. So they had just disembarked people who were on a Caribbean cruise. Okay, good. Thank you, Dawn, for checking in. So the people had just gotten off the ship back at Port Canaveral, and we had a group of 13 travel agents from all different agencies. I didn't know any of them. None of them were from Mickey Travels. And so they picked us up at Disney Springs, and we took Mir's transportation to Port Canaveral, about an hour drive. And then we got to see three staterooms, one concierge room, and one of those rooms was the Aurora Concierge Suite, and that is a two-bedroom suite. There are four of those aboard the Disney Wish. Two of them are two-story suites. Two of them are one-story. And so that was really cool. We got to see all the dining, the rotational dining, We got to see Worlds of Marvel, Arendelle. Excuse me. And then we got to see 1923. We only got to see the Walt Disney side of 1923, but our guide said that basically they look the same. Super cool, just really elegant. We got to see the Rose, which is where you can get some alcoholic beverages, and it is 18 and older. And then we also got to see Enchanté, and it was just incredible. Had a blast. We ate on board. We ate lunch. We ate at the Mercantile, which has pretty much everything you could ever want. We did see Hyperspace Lounge, and it was... thank you. I would say it's really cool, but I feel like what I was expecting, it was a tiny bit underwhelming. But the process of like getting into the lounge is really cool. It makes you feel like you're in Star Wars. And so that was really cool. Clamshell. So that was super cool to get to see Hyperspace Lounge. We got to see the Bayou, which is right by Hyperspace Lounge. It's just more so out in the open, and that is a bar, but they also do like trivia and games there. We got to see the Aqueduct. We got to see like the main stage area where they welcome everybody on board on embarkation day. And let me flip you. So I'm going to stop talking now and let you enjoy the ride. Nemo! Mr. Ray, hi Mr. Ray.
Nemo!
Oh, science is great, there's so much to know.
Thank you, Dean.
It's time to go.
What if Nemo's swimming out the sea?
Oh, don't worry. Just keep your eyes open for him along the way.
Nemo!
Nemo! Let's go explore, explore, explore. Let's go explore the big blue world.
Hey, Mr. Ray, we can't explore without Nemo.
I'm sure we'll see him any minute now.
Children
together,
which you don't remember at all.
Is he old, white stripes, and looks kind of like you when he's smaller?
Yes, have you seen him?
Seen who? Hi, I'm Dory.
Goodbye, friends. Open wide. Have you got any fillings?
All right. Welcome in, everybody who joined. There were a few people who joined the chat and on Ghost Mode while we were riding the ride. Welcome in. I hope everyone enjoyed that. I hope it streamed well. It seemed like it did. So let's go look at the aquarium. All right. That was super fun. I always like that ride. It's a good one. No lag. Perfect. All right. So when you are done with that ride, always make sure to check out the Discovery Center. So this is what you can see. There is an upper level too. A lot of people, I think, skip the upper level. But the upper level has sea turtles, sharks and rays, and dolphins. The lower level, you're gonna see turtle talk with fresh manatees and some ocean life. So they also have little kids activities that you can do in here. So you'll have to find, I don't know where the books are. Sometimes they're just right here. Oh, they're over here. Let's go grab one. They've moved them since the last time I was here. Hi. Thank you guys. So this is something really cool your kids can do, and it's totally free. Doesn't cost anything extra. So I always like to grab one or two or three when I'm here. So the little book has some stickers in it. And you can go on a fantastic little excursion and find some super cool fish. So here's the stickers that are in it. So once you find those animals, you put them in your sticker book. So these guys, let's see what these are. These are the moray eels. Yeah, so Will, I've been going on and off the Disney Wi-Fi just depending on what the stream is telling me. I wasn't on the Wi-Fi in that though. So I had to be on the Wi-Fi when I was walking in looking at Asha. Just because there was so much going on in the entryway, there were a lot of people coming in. I think some people got guardians, and then they got some some dining reservations going on tonight. Look at that starfish. Super cool. So yes, this is just a super cool little scavenger hunt. Make sure you do it. This is actually a really good place to sit and hang out too when it's really hot outside. It honestly has not been bad at all this trip. But this is such a fun place to just hang out and relax. Get your kids out of the... Oh, I found Dory. Maybe she's going to find Nemo. Super cool. I mean, there's little dark coves over here. You know, right there is a great sitting area. It's out of the way. It gets your kids inside, out of the heat. Take a little nap. These tell you what's in it and a little thing about them. And that's what I love about Disney. You know, it's a theme park, yes. But when you bring your kids here, they're actually learning something too, which I think is super cool. And I love that. And Epcot is supposed to be about, you know, innovation and design and using your imagination and creativity. So I think that that's really awesome that kids can learn. Again, welcome in. A couple more people, it looks like, have joined in ghost mode. So let's go. Let's go see what else we can find. So again, Turtle Talk is right across the way. Turtle Talk with Crush is right there. It's a 15-minute wait. I feel like that's just waiting one or two shows. Yes, Will. We're entertaining our kids, but they're getting an education and they don't even know it. So this is the manatees. They're probably up top. But really, oh, there's one over there in the corner. So these manatees have actually been on Disney Plus. The super cute show on Disney Plus. It's actually about Animal Kingdom, but they show you other animals as well in the park. And one of these little guys, Will knows his name. Oh, there's one up top too, right there. One of these little guys came to Disney with a hurt back fin. So his entire back fin was hurt and cut. And so what they had to do was they had to fix his little back fin. And so
right there.
Will, I'm pretty sure, knows the name of that. Nujima, I'm pretty sure Flower and Garden Fest ends. Oh man, if you hadn't have asked me, I would totally know, because, you know, I think it ends the end of May, beginning of June. Somebody else may have a better knowledge of that. Let's ask a cast member. They always know. When does Flower and Garden Fest end?
I believe it's May 27th.
Okay, I thought it was around the end of May. Yes, it is. It is a little longer. Okay, perfect. Thank you. You know, they asked me on the stream, and I'm like, if you hadn't have asked, I could have told you. So
I believe it was February 28th to May 28th.
Okay, perfect.
If I'm remembering correctly.
Yeah, I think it was around the end of May. Yep, around the end of May. Yep, the 27th. Yep, perfect. Yes, Lil Joe was his name. Super cute show. So here's the dolphins. And they're actually out swimming. And you can actually see the dolphins and the sharks in the Nemo ride. And so, oh, there's one up there. You can also see these up top, too, on the second story of this building. So if you go to the second story, you can also see that. There they are. So yes, the dolphins and the sharks in the tanks, you can also see in the Nemo ride. So. Sorry, the gimbal, I do think my phone is too heavy for it, because it has to refocus every now and then. So if it gets a little wonky, that's why. Yeah, cast members are so awesome. And you know, the thing I love about cast members is they will never tell you, I don't know. And if they don't know something, they will be like, you know what? I think it's this, but let me go ask somebody else who can help you. And I love that about them. So this is one of the cutest gift shops, in my opinion. It's not very big, but it's super cute. Look at these little Easter. Well, I'd use that as an Easter bucket, but it's a little shovel and pail. We've got this super cute little outfit, but I don't, it's $26.99. And I don't really know if it looks girly. Well, it's actually $24.99. Check the tag. I'd get one for Wesley, but I don't really know if it looks like a girl or a boy. They've got Hank plushes. Those are going to run you $29.99. And then they've got Tiny Baby Dory and Big Dory. And then they've got Nemo and Squirt. The little ones are going to run you $19.99. And then the Big Dory is going to run you $22.99. I love this because she has the little transfer tag on her. I think that's super cute. All right. I'm going to stop over here by the pens because Will wanted a certain pen. It would be fine for Wesley. I think so too, but I'm streaming, so I can't show them my AP because it's on my phone. Because they need, if you're an annual pass holder, they pretty much have gone away with the actual pass itself. Everything's on your phone now. So if you're getting a discount, you're going to have to show it on your phone. So if you want that AP discount, just get ready to show them your phone. All right. So let's look at these pins. I don't think any of these are the ones Will wanted. Nope. Although the Pooh Bear ones are super cute. They've got your sets over here. Oh, those are super cool. All right, well, I'm at Epcot again. Not tomorrow. We're at Epcot on Monday. That's our last day. We're at Epcot on Monday. So I'll have to grab some stuff. So here's your 2024 merch. This pin set right here is going to run you $34.99. But you get six pins. These other smaller ones here are going to run, they're yellow. So what is yellow? Let's go find what yellow. Yellow is $14.99. So they've got some Wish pins here. I have not seen these. That's actually really cute. $19.99. It looks like they just have the characters. Super cute. I actually kind of like that. This one lights up. And that one is going to run... That's a yellow. So that is $14.99. That's actually not a bad price for lighting up. Oh, well, this pin's coming home with me. That's yellow, so that's $14.99. I love their Mexico pins here. Super cute. They've got China. China is really cute because that's the year, it's the year of the dragon, actually. So that's really cute. Morocco. Silver. Typically, these smaller ones down here are going to be silver, which is $12.99, so make sure to look at that right there. Will, I don't see your pin that you wanted in here, so we'll have to go to another pin traders, I think. Here's all the Star Wars, Marvel pins. Yeah, I love the three Caballeros, so does Wyatt. All right, so we are gonna exit, and we're gonna head towards the Land Pavilion, do Living with the Land. I believe that was a 5-minute wait. I can't check my app. If you want to check the app, you totally can. You do not have to. I'll probably ride it no matter what. Yeah, okay, Surfer Girl, Epcot is one of those places now that I feel like used to be a half park, a half day park. There's just so much to do that I could spend 2 or 3 days here, especially adding, you know, especially if it's Flower and Garden Fest. And then especially adding Guardians of the Galaxy and then the new section and Moana. There's so much to do now. All right. There's the Epcot ball. Green line. Green line.
After he's done,
5 minutes. Perfect. That's what it's been most of the day. Now, yesterday when I looked, at one point it got up to like a 45-minute wait. Grab a cucumber. I know. You know what, though, Dean? You posted that salad the other day at Connections Cafe. And I honestly think sometimes that's why their food is so good here, is because Connections Cafe and most places on property are going to use those things that are grown, that Disney grows. Will, there's a few more places I'll look for you. I didn't think it was going to be in there. I just wanted to look. The Land featuring Soarin'. I can't do Soarin' though. It makes me a little nauseated.
Well,
So look out for the Flower and Garden Festival signs anywhere in the park right now. The topiaries aren't just around the World Showcase. You can see them anywhere. So go ahead and make sure you're looking for those as you're walking around the park.
No need to run.
Bye, Sherry. Thanks for joining in for a little bit. I know about getting up at 3 a.m. That's when we got up to come to Disney the other day. Here's Awesome Planet. Next show starts in 1 minute. I've actually never done that. And then here's Garden Grill Restaurant. It has breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's technically a prefix meal because it's a buffet, kind of a buffet. It's more served family style. You get as much as you want. And you see characters like Chip, Dale, and Mickey. Yes, well, I saw that today. And then, of course, there's just a quick service restaurant as well. Garden Grill, you do need reservations for, and I recommend making those at your 60-day mark. If you don't get them at 60 days, keep checking. Hi, Keith. Welcome in. 5 minutes. Hello. Thank you. Be nice to your cast members because they're so nice to us. I always like to tell them thank you, and I appreciate them so much. There's also some new items that were added in Living with the Land. So, yes, Sherry, Flower and Garden Fest is my absolute favorite. You know, I like food and wine, but here's the thing. I feel like with Flower and Garden Fest, you get food and wine and topiaries. So it's like the best of both worlds. So why not? You know what I mean? And I also, I've never done Festival of the Holidays. I would like to at some point. But, and I've never done Festival of the Arts. Again, I think I would rather do Festival of the Holidays over Festival of the Arts. Just one. Row five, thank you. Perfect. It was basically a walk-on. Just had to wait for one boat to unload. So it was basically a walk-on. And I have the back row to myself.
The land. Living with the land. Okay, ready? Go film.
Try to not talk during this so you can hear what is being said. So welcome in, everyone. Make sure to like, share out with your friends, follow us on Facebook and Instagram, and of course YouTube. And here we go. I've also never streamed this, so let's hope it works. And now I'm gonna let you enjoy.
Hi.
in there with us if you can hear me. Hang in there. Hopefully we'll be back soon. That's interesting. It says I have a really good connection.
One of those living systems is the rainforest. It's the most magnificent concentration of life.
Is it better now? To turn on the Wi-Fi, and I hope I'm back now.
In the desert, nature has created a very different, nonetheless beautiful living system. And while this arid landscape may seem lifeless and very much alive, the plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the meridian sun. The American prairie once appeared as desolate as the desert, but over time, rainwater and
you can smell Garden Grill right here. You can actually see Garden Grill up there. So, there they are. Welcome in, Brett.
In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods. Today, we're learning to live with the land, discovering better ways to grow food that will assure both human and environmental well-being.
Yeah.
Oh, here's one of the newer items that they just added right here, all that Little Mermaid stuff. It's brand new. So she's got all of her thingamabobs. And if you didn't know, you can book a live backstage tour of Living with the Land.
Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, sloppy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the world. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world.
Mickey heads in the tanks. I think it's super cute. And then one of the new additions for Flower and Garden Fest 2 is that this plant is now a Minnie Mouse head. She has a Minnie bow on. So typically if you ride this ride, you're going to see Mickey Mouse. Or if you ride during the holidays, you are going to see Santa Mickey. But this is now Minnie Mouse.
The common grains growing here,
and then over here you have Snow White's wishing well. So that's another thing that was added for Flower and Garden Fest, is her wishing well. I know I said I wasn't going to talk, but ask Will. That's really hard for me to do, is not talk. So we've got some rice in the grass right here, daylilies right here, and we've got some lemon plants.
Innovative brewing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and
eggplants are coming up.
Another innovation at work is our integrated pest management program. By outplanting our immediate group of beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, you're significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing
edible flowers, watermelon.
This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area.
This is brand new for Flower and Garden Fest 2. They have added a Winnie the Pooh section. So there's a cute little honeybee flying around. And I think that that is so adorable. There's currants and lettuce in Rabbit's garden.
Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit are these ground plants growing? It helps fields to make better control of diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve over 15 tons of food from our greenhouses and restaurants here at the land every year.
And then we've got on this side, I'm sorry, it's a lot of back and forth, friends, but I want you to see we're painting the roses red over here with Alice and the Queen of Hearts. And we're having a merry unbirthday.
Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing. That saves water and increases production. The aquaponics system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provide a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to use more while using less. In our lab, Epcot scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher yielding and better quality plants.
Scenes walking tour. Thank you for hanging in there. I know we kind of cut out there just a little bit, but living with the land. All right, so I was going to do Figment next, but if you would just rather me go to the Flower and Garden Fest, I can do that. Or, Dean, you're telling me that music at the end is a real banger, okay? True Disney fans know about that music. If you want me to go to Figment, I can do Figment, go see the Walt statue, or just head to Flower and Garden. So let me know what you want to see. I'll do anything. I probably won't stream the fireworks, though, just because I haven't seen this show and I want to enjoy it for myself. So maybe some gimbal craziness as I'm trying to get out. Okay. Perfect. And then as you exit Living with the Land, there is where you can sign up for the behind the scene tour. And then you've got the lightning lane for Soarin', and then the regular entrance for Soarin'. So here we go. We have got to go back up to get out. We've got to go back up to get out. Just let me know what you prefer. All right, Figment. Go straight to Flower and Garden, or we can see the new Dreamer statue. Or there's Moana. There's so much to do. Possibilities are endless. So here's Garden Grill again. And if you wanted a reservation for that and you didn't get one, keep looking on the app. While I'm here, I'm gonna switch out my fuel rod. So years ago, Will and I bought this fuel rod right here at Disneyland. And so all you have to do is swap it, put it in there, and it comes out right there. There we go. So we've got a new fuel rod. Because I will need to charge my phone after the stream. So we are off again. It's looking a little dark outside now, so. Yes, December 2017, we bought that fuel rod at Disneyland. It was like, what, $25, $30? And you can swap it out as much as you want in the parks. And then you can recharge it at night at your resort or hotel. It's really come in handy for us. Now, Universal does have the fuel rods, but the problem is Universal is going to charge you for those to swap. They charge you to swap and to buy it. So Disney does not charge you a fee to swap it out. Go head to Flower and Garden, do some of that stuff. So here's Butterfly Landing. It is currently closed right now because it's dark outside. But there's Butterfly Landing. We've got Skip the Bee over here. Yeah, Dean, Moana is super pretty at night. I totally walked the wrong way for that though, Dean. Here is Figment off to my right. You can meet Figment there, Journey into the Imagination with Figment, and then there's a little Pixar short film festival. Oh, that popcorn smells good. We've got Woody, Bo Peep, and her sheep. Bo Peep and her sheep. Billy Goat and Gruff. There's Billy Goat and Gruff.
why they said to go wait.
So that is where Timon and Pumbaa were last year. And for some odd reason, they have the path closed off here. Is that what you were trying to tell me, Dean? Yep, that pathway is still closed off. Where do you go, Dean? Do I have to go? I'm gonna have to go back to the right then, aren't I? They should really tell you that before you go back there, because everyone is going back there. Well, that's just crazy, friends.
Okay, so that's
the last
okay.
There's the ball obstructed by this beautiful, crazy building here. All right, now that construction right there, blocking your way to World Showcase from over here, that's kind of crazy. That's my two cents, that's all I'll say. So that was a fun little mile-long detour out of the way. So let's do Moana. Or I'm gonna go do Walt because I haven't seen him. Yeah, construction is rude. And as beautiful as Journey of Water is, it's totally obstructed the view of Spaceship Earth from back here. So that's another soapbox I have.
Run and jump! How are you running and doing horseplay in a crowded area?
That's beautiful. Beautiful. So here is the pathway lit up. Super cute. Love it. Figment.
No, I didn't. Who is it?
The guy using that screaming song.
Well, I just walked in at the right time. Bring tears to your eyes, y'all. Thank you, Amy.
Yes, it was. Well, colors of the wing.
Now, if that wasn't just the most amazing thing I've ever seen, it honestly almost brought a tear to my eye. But if you know me, you know why. I could not have timed that any better. That was just so amazing. Gorgeous. I mean, really, Dean, that was... Woo! So amazing. Is the man, Mr. Disney himself. The pathway lights up. Look at it from this direction. Wow. Just wow. Man. Photo pass spot right here. Get your picture. Get that photo pass. Get your picture made with Walt. You will not regret it in the least bit. It was lovely. It was lovely. That is, man. Whew. And that, I'm telling y'all, that's why the mouse keeps taking my money, because it does stuff like that. It does stuff like that, and I said, take it all, Mickey Mouse. Take all my money now. That's why. It's gorgeous. So let's go see some of World Showcase, and then I'll try to end the stream over there. Yeah, I mean, that. Me too. That Pocahontas song made me teary-eyed too. So, heading to World Showcase. Creations shop is over here. Connections Cafe is over here. Ooh, some drama is happening on the bench. Okay, Club Cool is over here as well. So that section was World Celebration. It's my first time seeing it. It's amazing. They could not have done a better job with that, for sure. Will, let me look in the creation shop for that pen. Of course, I'm streaming, so I'd have to come back for it, to use my discount if I see it. Let me see. And if I can even remember what it looks like, that's another thing. Because my brain don't work like it used to, friends. All right. I think the pens are going to be this way. I'm going to walk here super fast. Oh, well, there they are. There's the Figment. They just brought these back. And it's coming home with me. Will told me to be responsible, but I think that it would be irresponsible to not bring Figment home. It's $88, and I get a discount with my AP, so he's gonna come home with me. It's amazing. Okay, back to what Will wanted. Got a little distracted there. Back to what Will wanted. These are super cute classic tees right here. Sweatshirts, just classic Mickey Mouse. You got these super cute classic mugs right here. You got Mickey, Minnie, Goofy, and Donald for $16.99. All right, pens. We're gonna walk this way. This Epcot Spirit jersey is super cute, and there's some Flower and Garden merch right there. Oh, that's the Flower and Garden merch right in the front, of course. I'll have to get this for Wyatt, too. Alright, let's go look over here. This is where the pens are in this store, so maybe we'll get lucky, Will. If I see it. Oh, they're over here by the wall. They moved some of it. If you see it, Will, stop me and tell me that it's it. That I found it. I'm not even sure what I'm looking for anymore. It's not Marvel. It's not Star Wars. It's not the themes. Winnie the Pooh. No, I don't think it's there at all. All of those are kind of old school stuff that they've had for a while. Here's that Ashley Eckstein merch. She actually was wearing this when she was here not that long ago. Yes, the Figment backpack is iridescent. It's beautiful. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. This one is pretty new too, right here. This blue sequence lounge fly. It is all sequence. All sequence down it. The back is not, which I like. The back is not. There's a zipper. So it's going to be like all your other lounge flies, mini lounge fly backpacks. It's $98 though, so that I don't think is in my budget. But I do like that one. It's really cute. Here's all your Spidey merch right here. Spider-Man. There's all your Spidey merch. They have the Marvel backpack. They've got some really cute shirts for Wyatt and Wesley. That's a little girl shirt though. Super cute. All right, so let's keep moving.
Keep an eye out for the Remy one.
They've got all their Spirit jerseys and ears right here in the front, in one of the entrance fronts. There's like four or five entrances to this place. I've wanted these ears for a long time, and if I get that backpack, I may have to get these ears. They are $34.99. They are Figment ears. But if I get the backpack, I'll have to get the ears, and I have a Figment shirt, so I'll have to get that. And then they've got the peach. The peach lounge fly. And this is a different kind of sparkle than the blue. To me, this looks more like scales. It looks scaly to me. The blue one, the sparkles were in a pattern. The sparkles were in a pattern on the blue one. Let's see how much this pink one costs. The pink one is peach. It's peach, I guess. It's going to run you $98. I'd rather have Figment for that price. Okay, so we are walking out, and to our left is going to be Guardians. To our right, there's this super cool little play area. I know, Tina, the peach is gorgeous. I don't know if it, like, if you could see how gorgeous it was on the stream. Mission Space is to your left as well. Hi, Kimberly. Welcome in. We are at Flower and Garden Fest. We've ridden some rides. Test track is right in front of us. No, you're fine. Thank you. Test track is right in front of us. Test track was down a little bit today. It went down for a while today. And then once it came back up, the line got really long. And that's another one. If you're doing lightning lanes here and using Genie Plus, Test Track, Frozen, and Remy are always going to be the first to fill up. We've got the Frozen Slushy Coke stand. I don't know if those are free or not. Are those free? Because they kind of look free. And then we have Brunchcot right here for International Flower and Garden Fest. People love Brunchcot. They have the avocado toast, biscuits and gravy, and then the fried cinnamon roll bites. They've got the Fruit Loop shake. They've got the Fruit Loop shake, the peach Bellini, and then they've got a coffee cocktail. So, at Brunchcot. So let's keep going this way. Oh no, the frozen slushies are right there. I didn't see an entrance. I was like, are they giving away free slushies? They wouldn't do that. They're smart enough to not do that. All right, so we are headed to the Citrus Blossom. This is a great place to. Pro tip from your Mickey Travels travel agent. Citrus Blossom is open from open and close to park. And am I hungry? You know what? My mom and I ate at... Actually, we didn't eat a full meal, but I met her at Disney Springs at the boathouse, and we had the ducky cocktail, and we had a shrimp cocktail and some chips with pimento cheese. So I'm kind of sort of hungry. I can try some food. I don't mind at all. But the Citrus Blossom pro tip here, they have air conditioning inside, and if you have a kid and it's really hot, this is the place to go and kind of hang out inside. It's never really super crowded. We actually hung out here with Will's parents in June of last year. So, I'm kind of thirsty though. I could honestly get something to eat or drink. So they've got the shrimp. I could try the shrimp and the smoothie. Let's do that. Oh, well, thank you, Dawn. Can you mobile order the flower and garden stuff? I don't know if you can. So here they've got the orange lemon smoothie and a souvenir orange bird cup. And you can see that orange bird cup right there. They've got water and then beverages with alcohol. They have a key lime wine slush, and I had that last year. It was super good. Snacks, they have the orange sesame tempura shrimp with orange chili sauce and a lemon meringue pie. Yeah, connections probably. I kind of wanted to try some of this stuff though, so that's super nice of you to offer, but I think I'm gonna try some of this. It sounds really good. I'm not too hungry. I really don't want the orange bird slush, the cup though, because we already have one. But maybe I can give it away to one of my clients or something. Hello, welcome in, Disney Master Chef. Thank you though, Dawn. I do appreciate it. I really do. But I really want to try this. Super yummy. I love the citrus blossom, guys. I ate some really good food here last time. So maybe I'll get some food here and then I will go hang out at a table for a little bit and kind of give you my thoughts on what I'm eating and then end the stream. All right. I'm going to do the orange sesame tempura shrimp and then the orange lemon smoothie.
Is it just the smoothie or the fresh?
Just the smoothie will be fine.
$12.
Is it the mention
bet?
Yes, ma'am. All right, so you can get it without the orange bird sipper. We have the orange bird sipper, so I'm going to skip that this time.
$4.79.
Thank you. So they give you a ticket with a number at Flower and Garden Fest. All the booths do. You take your number here on your ticket, and you show it to them, and they'll give you your food and beverages. And then let's go sit somewhere and enjoy. Thank you. Thank you. So for the shrimp, they call my number when it's ready. So we're gonna wait for that. Yes, thank you.
$4.78.
So let's stack it up and let's go find a table. All of the Flower and Garden merch is in here too, so this is a great place to sit. I've got my water bottle that's filled with water. They filled it up for me at the boathouse, so I'm gonna sit here. So bear with me. And then I'm going to get a book. Oh, I found the Judy Hopp egg. The Judy Hopp's egg is up there if you're doing the extravaganza. The Judy Hopp egg is, ooh, I'm Kimball crazy, right there. And the orange blossom. So if you're doing that, I just gave that to you. So you're welcome. All right, let me get this on a stand. This is super cute over here. Let me get this on a stand. I'm sorry, it's gonna get really crazy just for about 5 seconds. So like I said, we have sat in here for a while before. We just love it in here. It's super cozy and I love it. Okay, I'm screwing on the bottom, so just bear with me. Okay, setting it up on the table. Turn it around to me. Okay. Okay. All right, going to Texas Roadhouse. Okay, perfect, Will. All right, so here's the shrimp. The tempura shrimp is right here with the chili sauce. Mmm. Oh, it smells so good. And then here's the orange smoothie. Let's go ahead and try the smoothie first because I am really thirsty. It's really refreshing. It tastes like a dreamsicle to me, but it's super refreshing, really good. Mm. So good.
That was a mistake.
Really, really good. And then I have my resort mug that I filled up before I got here with Coke, so I didn't have to buy Coke in the park. And I got my refillable water bottle here. I'm This says it's Sunshine Tree Terrace, I think is what it is. I honestly need to get a little booklet. I'm pretty sure this is the sun, or the sun, the orange blossom. I don't know. Got me second guessing now. Okay. So I got some water. Let's dive into this shrimp. Ooh. Oh my gosh. You're right, Will. Oh my gosh. The shrimp is cooked perfectly. And this crust, oh my gosh, is so good. And it's got a sweet chili sauce on it. So it's, you've got the sweet and the spicy. Let me move over a little bit because that, I noticed that light is in y'all's face. Oh my gosh. Y'all. That is an 11 out of 10. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, it's so good. Mm. Wow. And there's 5 of them. And I think this one was only, I think this one was $6. My whole total was 15. Between the smoothie and the shrimp, and there's 5 shrimp. Oh my gosh. Oh. Well, I got the fried tempura shrimp with sweet chili sauce, and there's sesame on it. Oh my gosh.
Mm. You found her.
Mm. The crust, the breading is so perfectly crunchy. It's amazing. So good. Mm. I have to hurry though, because the park is closing soon. It's 8:25. But Mandy, you can do Garden Grill anytime. If I'm here at Flower and Garden, I would much rather do the Flower and Garden. I've heard some mixed reviews about Garden Grill too. But yes, the orange blossom is where I am. It's so good. So good. I'm gonna go out on a limb. I love it. It's really good. Yes, Will. It's a citrus blossom. It's where we sat for a while with your dad last year with Wesley. My heavens. Mm. It's really good. Sorry, y'all have to watch me eat, but I'm actually not that sorry because it's really good. Yeah, that sweet chili sauce is really good. I enjoy it. This little area is really cute. And the way that they decorate it for Flower and Garden is really amazing. So again, I got the smoothie without the orange bird. Sipper, but you can get the orange bird sipper, so. Sorry, my mom texted me. I'm here with my mom this trip, so I had to text her back. So yes, if you did not catch the beginning of the stream, we got here yesterday. We did Animal Kingdom. We went straight to Animal Kingdom from the airport. And we spent all day at Animal Kingdom. We did so much. Of course, follow the Hitchhiking Bones on Instagram and YouTube. My Instagram is PixieVacayPlanner, and my Facebook is Mickey Travels Jillian Bone. So you can find me on both of those, and you can see some things that we did at Animal Kingdom yesterday. We did Kilimanjaro Safaris twice. We did it once in the morning, mid-morning, right before lunch. And then we did it once, and we were the last safari of the day. It was so cool because we got to see different animals both times. And so make sure to hit that. The only thing we didn't do is Flight of Passage, and that's because I didn't want to wait 120 or 40 minutes. And I also didn't want to pay however much to ride it. So, great day at Animal Kingdom. Today, this morning, I went to a travel agent training for the Disney Wish. I met some other travel agents that aren't with Mickey Travels. It was like all the travel agents were invited that wanted to come. And so we toured the Disney Wish this morning, and nobody was on it when we got on. It had been docked after sailing, and man, they kick those people off and clean it up fast. Because by the time we got on the ship at 10 o'clock, no one was on it, and over half the ship was perfectly clean. And so then people started arriving on the ship around 11, but honestly, we didn't really see anyone in the hallways or anything until around 1. And so we got to eat lunch on it, and so then after that, I hit Disney Springs, and we ate at the boathouse. My mom and I just sat at the bar. We didn't have a reservation, and we just sat at the bar, and we got the little duck drink there with our rubber duckies. And then we got a pimento cheese dip with chips, and then we split a little shrimp cocktail, and their shrimp was really good. I've had so much shrimp today. What is wrong with me? I guess that's not a bad thing. And so then I headed over here. So I'm gonna hurry up and wrap it up because I know the fireworks are gonna start at 9 and it's 8:30 and the park closes at 8:30. So let me see if I can get a spot. Luminous is the new show. So, Will, honestly, I haven't tried anything else. This is the best of the fest. So good. It is kind of messy, but it's really good. I'm trying to wipe my hands because now I have shrimp on my hands. So let me get my hand wipes out. Sorry. I bring my Clorox disinfecting wipes, and I also bring Neutrogena face wipes. It's a makeup remover, but what I use this for is when it's really hot and sweaty outside, I like to dab my face and my arms off and get the sweat kind of off the back of my neck,
because
too. The Flower and Garden merch is always really cute. I always enjoy a good Flower and Garden Fest merchandise. They do a really good job with it. Of course, I think it's one of their most popular festivals that they do. Pack everything up. You know what? I'm gonna end the stream here just because, again, I haven't seen this fireworks show and I really want to see it, me and take pictures of it. And so I'm gonna do that. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. It's been really fun. I'm sorry we had to keep pushing the stream back. I was having some issues. It wouldn't let me connect to this stream. It was showing it as unlisted for some odd reason. And so, thank you for hanging in there with us. Thank you for watching. Thank you for our ghost host chat moderators. Thank you for everyone who came into the stream and stuck with us. Thank you so much. Happy birthday, LLL. I'm going to wrap it up here, throw my trash away, and I'm going to go see Luminous. I haven't seen it before, and I'm really excited. So, I'm going to do that. I'm going to finish this, and it has been so fun. Thank you to everyone who tuned in. Make sure to watch my All-Star Sports live stream. It was really short just because I was so tired. I'll try to do a vlog of it later. I'll have some more vlogs coming up on my channel. I'm going to try to email Dawn some pictures of the wish and try to get some videos or some shorts made on our channel. So go ahead and bop that like button, ring the bell so you know when we go live. Thank you so much for hanging in there with us. We have had so much fun. It's just, it's amazing. We got to hear Pocahontas Colors of the Wind. So have a great night, everybody. It is 8:34 here and the fireworks start at 9. So I'm gonna wrap it up. And thank you again, everyone. Thank you to Will for watching our two boys at home and allowing me to come on this agent trip and for letting my mom come, because you totally did not have to do that. But he's the best daddy ever. He does everything for our kiddos. So I know that they're all taken care of, and I know he's having a blast. Make sure that you watch for my live stream on Saturday morning for What's Brewing with the Bones, and I'll recap my entire trip. And I'm so excited. If you need a travel agent, my services are 100% free to you. And by the way, if you're booking a Disney vacation, you're paying a travel agent fee whether you use one or not. So you might as well use one. And I am here to help you for free. And so I would love to help all of you. My Facebook is Mickey Travels Jillian Bone. My email is jbone@mickeytravels.com. And thank you for hanging in there with us. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, my family. I love you guys. And I'm gonna go enjoy the fireworks. Don't forget to hurry back.